watching CN2 News, your number one source for award-winning hometown coverage.
Honoring those who have served, I'm CN2's Catherine Rioli, and I'll have more on how these wreaths are paying tribute to fallen soldiers.
In an effort not to kill cats, an animal shelter is taking a new approach to managing the population. I'm CN2's Alexandria Savage with that new practice and how it benefits felines and the community.
Plus, a local nonprofit that helps our neighbors in need seeing a big donation today. We have just how much next. Your news starts right now. Good evening, I'm Laura Bree Monday. We're certainly glad you're here with us tonight.
And I'm Renee O'Neill, filling in for Lucas McFadden. First up tonight, honoring the ones who gave it all this Christmas season. Hundreds of wreaths being delivered to Rock Hill this Wednesday. Those wreaths will soon be laid on hundreds of veterans' graves, honoring them for their ultimate sacrifice during a special ceremony that will take place this weekend. CN2's Catherine Andreoli has more on how this initiative, Wreaths Across America, is paying tribute to fallen heroes.
An emotional tribute Wednesday for two local veterans honoring those who gave the ultimate sacrifice protecting the nation.
Well, it goes to the heart. When we present them, you just get the feeling you wish that you could do more.
Hundreds of wreaths like the one you see here will honor fallen soldiers on Saturday. It's a ceremony one veteran says hits close to home.
So to present a wreath on their graves, they're just not here anymore.
Gino Del Bono is participating in Wreaths Across America. The organization places handmade wreaths on the graves of veterans nationwide. Saturday, more than 800 will decorate Grandview Memorial Park in Rock Hill.
This year we raised $8,000, a little over, and bought 800 plus wreaths.
Al Guest is the president of Rolling Thunder's local chapter. The organization supports veterans like himself and brought the project to Rock Hill.
For several years, Wreaths Across America was done at Fort Mill, and for some reason it stopped. So that was brought to our attention, Rolling Thunder. And we decided that we would pick that program up and continue with it.
Boxes of wreaths were delivered Wednesday morning before serving as a symbol of honor and a reminder that freedom is not free.
As a veteran, I can't think of anything better or more important to do than honor those that went before me. I hope when it's my time to go that there's someone coming along behind that will continue this tradition.
Honoring the fallen in Rock Hill, Catherine Andreoli, CN2 News.
The wreath laying ceremony will begin at 10 o'clock Saturday morning at Grandview Memorial Park. It is open to the public. To learn more about Wreaths Across America, you can visit their website at wreathsacrossamerica.org.
The Fort Mill Care Center being presented a check of hope. The women with the TGK Women's Club giving $1,500 to the Fort Mill Care Center this Wednesday. The ladies raising the money at their recent garage sale. They have it every year at the TGK Fall Festival. The Fort Mill Care Center helps those in town with utility bills, food, and more. Leaders say this donation will help them through the entire year.
One thing we love about the Care Center is that all the money stays in the community, goes directly. There's no administrative fees that come out or anything like that.
These are the checks that we count on to get us through the year. Our donations obviously are heavier this time of year, kind of like retail. We depend on November and December to fatten up the coffers. We so don't get big donations in the summertime. We don't get big food donations. So this is a very, very important time of year for us.
We also learned today the director of the Fort Mill Care Center, Carol Higgins, will actually be retiring in February after 20 years of service.
Well, a 17-year-old student in Lancaster County is charged after drugs were found in his car on school property, according to school leaders. The district safety and transportation office says a 17-year-old Buford High School student will be charged with simple possession of marijuana and suspended from school after the district's drug dog, which you see in the picture, detected drugs inside of the student's vehicle parked at the school.
After a special meeting, Chester County School Board is selecting a location for that proposed career and workforce readiness center for the district. School leaders say the land is located in the area of York Technical College's Chester campus. Leaders say this property provided the best overall value to taxpayers. It will serve all three high schools and aims to expand the adult education for 21st century careers. Now note, this is all based on the upcoming bond referendum passing. Voters in Chester County will head to the polls on February the 13th to vote on a $38 million bond referendum. Leaders say this will not raise taxes. Many other school upgrades are also included in the bond. Driving around, especially in the country, you may have noticed a lot of stray cats. Officials say a longer breeding season may be to blame.
CN2's Alexandria Savage stopped by the Lancaster County Animal Shelter to see how a new program is fixing the problem.
Lancaster County has started a new initiative to trap, neuter, and release stray cats to prevent the number of felines from growing.
All the feral cats come in, they're fixed, or had the rabies shot, they get the ear clip, identify them as a TNR cat, and they release back where they come from.
No, this won't cost you any money. This past July, administrators voted to put money towards the TNR program out of county funds.
We've probably fixed, you know, anywhere from 75 to 100 cats a month since then.
Alan Williams with the Lancaster County Animal Shelter says the new program is a progressive alternative. Cats aren't being sought out, but when complaints are made, the cats are caught and brought into the shelter.
They're community cats, so our community has to do their job to kind of help us.
Williams says one cat can produce 40 to 50 cats a year, so this is just a precaution to keep the population down, which is much better than the alternative, euthanization.
Putting the cats to sleep, that's not the answer. It just don't work. The numbers, they don't decrease from year to year.
Williams says the shelter is looking to expand to a larger location with construction beginning late next year so that they can better accommodate the county's animals' needs.
We try to adopt out and fix as many as we can, but we can't keep them all because we get so many.
Shelter officials say the animal shelter will be making even more progressive steps to continue helping its furry friends.
With this TNR and just a little bit more space, we can say, get there, we can be a no-kill shelter, and we are on the way there.
For now, taking it one paw at a time. In Lancaster, Alexandria Savage, CN2 News.
Williams says animal shelters nationally are moving towards becoming no-kill sanctuaries and instead sterilizing felines to prevent overpopulation. Well, sticking with the Lancaster County Animal Shelter, we brought you the story a couple of weeks ago about a bus driver being bitten by a dog while protecting herself and the students on board.
Well, this Wednesday, the dog still remains in quarantine. The dog on your screen, Chief, actually chased a female student onto a bus. It happened on JBH Denton Road on November 29th. So the Lancaster County bus driver amazingly reacted quickly, tried to close the bus doors, and now we're learning from the police report that the dog's owner actually chased the dog, and it was the owner's arm that got caught in the bus door. So when the door opened to release the arm, the dog got on board and bit the bus driver's elbow. The dog is a pit terrier mix and has been quarantined for the past 2 weeks since the incident. The owner still has to decide if he's going to court to fight to keep the dog or turning the dog over to the county.
Well, members of one nonprofit stepping out of state lines to help our homeless neighbors in Charlotte. Kevin Lilly, who is the founder of the Mobile Shower Ministry in Lancaster County, headed to Uptown Charlotte this week with many others to hand out food, blankets, hugs, and prayers to those who were living on the streets. The group plans to head back next week.
Fort Mill School is looking to bring a little Disney magic to its school in a unique way. The theater class and the Gateway to Technology Robotics Club collaborating on a STEAM-inspired prop for the school's rendition of Beauty and the Beast, Junior. We were there for this dress rehearsal. The Beauty and the Beast is coming this Friday again to Fort Mill Middle School, and the kids have been working hard to bring this classic movie to life. Moving set pieces, wonderfully choreographed dances, and memorable songs await you. Again, the show starts at 6:30 p.m. this Friday night. That's December the 15th. Tickets are $8 for adults and $4 for students. Here's our latest Arrowpoint Federal Credit Union picture of the day. Members of the Heart to Heart Foundation gathering today for a heartfelt lunch, also holding a board meeting while we were all together. The nonprofit organization advocates for women's heart health and was founded in 2012. I'm proud to be part of it. Right now, plans are underway for the Queen of Hearts Gala. That's February the 3rd. It will be held at McBride Hall there at Winthrop. Want to see your photo as picture of the day? Just email it to news@cn2.com. And just ahead on CN2 News.
Teens and drinking are two words that should never go together. So teens drinking and driving really shouldn't be an issue. But sadly it is. What some leaders are doing to combat the problem. Plus,
they've already won over 50 trophies with their dance team. I'm CN2's Danietta Tomo showing you the Diamond Divas of Rock Hill.
Welcome back to CN2 News.
Retailers are pledging to prevent teen drinking and alcohol-related collisions here in York County. And this week, they're being recognized for their efforts. The York County Pact, which stands for Preventing Alcohol Collisions and Teen Drinking, celebrating the service of York County law enforcement and retailers for protecting our youth and preventing DUIs. Retailers are training staff on checking IDs and educating them on serving laws. It's part of an effort by the Alcohol Enforcement Team of York County to stop minors from being served alcohol and then getting behind the wheel.
Keep the retailers on their feet and understand that this isn't just a check to see if they're doing right or wrong. It's to help save somebody's life ultimately, whether it's to prevent addiction with alcoholism in the future or prevent DUIs here in York County.
The event was hosted by Keystone Youth Services, Rock Hill Police, the York County Coroner's Office and Sheriff's Office, and others also attending.
Well, eating healthy can be very time consuming, but with this business, it believes it can be quick and easy. Fresh Vibes Juice Bar, located on Ebenezer Road in Rock Hill, is not just a juice bar, but rather a one-stop shop for all your vegan and organic needs. They serve a variety of juices as well as vegan food and just recently organic coffee. All the produce the owners use are from local farmers, and each meal is handcrafted when ordered. With two drive-through windows, they offer quick service and a wide variety of healthy options for even the pickiest customers. CN2 spoke with the owner, and she tells us how the name Fresh Vibes came about.
We get everything, local produce shipped in every day, local when we can get it, but the produce is shipped in every day from suppliers all around Rock Hill. I run out all the time buying new stuff, vegan and vegetarian food as well, so everything, we try to make it as healthy as possible and as fresh as possible, hence the name Fresh Vibes for our customers.
CN2's Business Spotlight is brought to you by Craig Wilkerson, attorney at law. Knowledge is power. Know your rights.
They are thinking of expanding soon and are thankful for the community for all the support. It opens Monday through Friday at 6 a.m. and Saturday at 8 and is closed on Sunday.
Looking good, and here is tonight's CN2 forecast. It's been a cold day and the chilly weather continues into Thursday, with a high of 51 degrees, a low of 31 as we head to the weekend, and early next week we'll be back in the high 50s and even making it into the 60s. The best chance to see some rain will be late on Sunday.
Well, in tonight's digital dashboard, the Chester County Sheriff's Office posting these photos on Facebook saying deputies enjoyed visiting Joshua at his police-themed birthday party. According to the post, Joshua says he wanted to be a police officer since he was born. He got to wear a deputy hat and even got a tour in a police cruiser. And students at South Point High School are back at it again with some cool gadgets. Engineers were testing the rear wheel programming for this driver station that is controlled by an Xbox controller. Students also used a 3D printer to make a phone holder for the robot.
Because every robot needs a phone holder.
Yes, pretty cool.
Just ahead on CN2 News, they may be young in a courtroom, but you don't want to go up against them. Just after this break, we hang out with the middle school state champions. Welcome back to CN2 News.
Middle schoolers putting their talent of arguing to a good use. Fortman Middle School students winning the mock trial state championships in Columbia, and now they are celebrating. The team is made up of 14 students and attorney coaches training them. Preparing for the championships, they practice 4 hours a week for 2 months. One of the parents promised if they were to win, there would be a party. Well, they held up on their end of the bargain. Again, after a lot of hard work, they took home the trophy. The attorney coaches tell us more about the case and what the students got out of the experience.
It was a civil case about a wrongful termination, whistleblower statute type case. So pretty complicated case for middle schoolers, but they did a good job.
It's one of the few activities at this age that requires kids to think on their feet. Those skills never go away.
Lamel says he started doing mock trials when he was in middle school. Now the coaches, both attorneys, are from the Tri County area and are volunteering their time to give back. For Fort Mill middle schoolers, the state championships are the highest level of competition. In high school, there are national championships as well.
Great job.
Yes, and he's known around the community for his Quilts of Valor ceremonies.
Harvey Mayhill, a good CN2 friend, is all about giving back to others, and what better time for it than the holiday season with a Christmas party. Mayhill wanted to thank those who live a life of service, from the women who made 75 quilts to be awarded to veterans, to the veterans themselves, this one remembering how he spent his Christmas in Vietnam many Decembers ago. For Harvey Mayhill, it's all about showing appreciation.
You know, people don't get the thank yous that they should get. And this is our payback to say thank you.
Mayhill passed out golden pins with the American flag and an angel on them. He says he even mailed the same kind of pin to President George W. Bush when he was in office.
Ryan has written a story that's unexpected but right. Some of the stuff that happens, people are going to be like, oh my God.
Even though I think I know it all, they throw things at me story-wise I never could have imagined.
And even though everybody knows that it's the second in a trilogy, it feels like its own thing.
Ryan needs to work on his walkie sounds. Ridiculous. New director, can't even just learn a walkie sound.
It feels like the storylines are becoming more established. We're really getting to know these new characters. Also with the characters that we know and love, we're seeing their lives change.
Everything is being shifted in an opposite way to what the audience expected after 7. Ryan's made Star Wars fresh and new.
I'm hoping it'll be a little shocking, but I'm hoping it'll feel real and honest.
It's our most ancient story of good against evil, told in the most fascinating way, but it has a real spiritual depth to it.
It's about family, and that's what's so powerful about it.
Watch what you want when you want with Comporium Video On Demand. Here are this week's featured movies. Simply click over to channel 700 and check out one of these great films, or choose from one of the many available for you to watch at your convenience and from the comfort of your home. Watch what you want when you want with Comporium Video On Demand. CN2 at the Movies is brought to you by American Air Heating and Cooling.
This is CN2 Sports. They travel all over the Carolinas and even go to Atlanta to compete in dance competitions.
They recently won 5 trophies in a competition. CN2's Danielle DeTomo introduces us to a dancing team on the rise.
1, 2, 3, 4. It all started with an idea, and then it became a real thing. Girls in the neighborhoods of Rock Hill decided to try out a new dance team, and now they call themselves the Diamond Divas.
Well, I moved here about 5 years ago, and there were so many girls in my neighborhood just not doing anything, but they wanted to dance, they wanted to cheer. I see them doing little stuff on the side, and I've been dancing since I was 3 years old. So I decided I'm gonna start a dance team. Even though I know no one here, I'm gonna start a dance team. And April 4th, 2014 is when I started my team. That was the first day of practice. We had 12 girls show up. That was awesome because I wasn't expecting that. So after that, we just continued to practice, and girls came, girls left, you know, things like that. But 4 years later, almost 4 years later, we're still here.
Even though they have been around for 4 years, new girls join every year. But some of the girls have been with the Diamond Divas since the beginning.
Because I can help people and to get where I am, help people get where I am.
That we're all a family. Like, I see everybody dancing, so I just wanted to try it. Seeing people on TV, and I just want to find the closest thing to me where I could dance.
Just standing outside of this building, you wouldn't know that there is a dance studio through those doors. Well, this is the studio that the Diamond Divas of Rock Hill practice. These girls are ages 4 through 18, and they bring a lot of flavor to their dances.
We go through ballet, we go through hip hop, we go through majorette, we do lyrical, we do facial expressions and body movement, and just bringing the crowd in, actually knowing how to put on a show. I encourage that everybody bring their girls into this team because it's very uplifting. It brings out the best in them, and it teaches them life skills and dance skills. Because it is a competitive team. So you can't just get away with being cute and doing some turns. You have to put everything into it. So it teaches them to be tougher as they grow up, that they can do whatever they want to do.
Practicing hard for their next competition, that will be in January. That will do it for CN2 Sports. I'm Danielle DeTomo.
Thanks, Danielle.
Also want to mention the South Point Stallions football team recognized Tuesday night at the basketball game. The Stallions basketball team hosted Northwestern. It was a close game, but the Stallions came out on top, beating Northwestern 80-78.
Well, thank you so much. We hope you have a great night, and we'll be back here tomorrow night with a brand new newscast at 6.
Have a good one. Also check out cn2.com. Have a good one, everyone.